dear students, let me welcome you to this episode of DAMS Medicine Unplugged. This is a series on YouTube where we have covered a lot of topics in detail, where we talk about how a disease looks like on radiology or lab and how it all affects the clinical management of the patient. And often we have picked up topics which are very high yield for the exams, and often some of those are actually important for the residents as well. So in the same line, today I am taking a topic which is a very, very important spotter for radiology residents, as well as a multiple choice question which is of differentiator kind of a multiple choice question, which is of a tough level. And I saw a question on this topic in this year's JIPMER PG exam. So I think it is a very, very good idea to, you know, follow the topic on this unplugged video. And if you have given the CS JIPMER PG entrance exam, you will appreciate the topic as well. So let's start discussing the topic here. To understand the topic, I will take it from a resident's perspective. If you're a resident appearing for the exam, especially if you're a radiology resident appearing for your MD exam, what they will do is they will typically keep an X-ray like this in front of you as a spotter. This is a chest X-ray. But what do you think is the problem? Now, I want you to look at the right lung field and look at the inframedial part of the right lung field. Do you think there is some kind of a opacity here? Yes, that the inframedial part of the right lung looks opaque. There is some opacity, haziness, and the right heart border looks blurred there. And we feel that the cardiac silhouette looks widened here. And when you look at the ribs are anteriorly, when you look at the, follow the ribs from posterior to anterior, the anterior ribs, they appear more vertically oriented. What do you think? So whenever we see such an appearance, we start thinking of a chest wall deformity called as pectus excavatum, or we may say depressed sternum. And this is very, very important that as a radiology resident, you are supposed to identify this on a chest X-ray PA view. But if they ask you what are the findings, let me, you know, kind of summarize it for you. The X-ray is showing blurring of the right heart border that we saw here. There is increased density in the inframedial lung zone that we saw. The posterior ribs are more horizontally placed and the anterior ribs were more vertically placed. There was displacement of the heart towards the left and widening of the cardiac silhouette. This is happening because the heart is compressed by the deformity. And, you know, if this is a short case kind of a thing where the examiner would always ask you what you want to see to confirm your suspicion, the easiest thing to do here would be a lateral view. Although, you know, most of the modern resident will jump to CT scan here, but the easiest thing to do is a lateral view. And you can see in this lateral view how the sternum is depressed. And this is the, you know, confirmatory here. The PA view was giving us a suspicion that we are looking at a chest wall deformity, but we could confirm it by looking at the lateral view. And today there is a role of CT in this, these kind of patients to determine, you know, not only to detect the deformity on CT, it is very obvious actually, but also to do a pre and post-op assessment of the severity of the disease. I have taken a sample case of pectus excavatum for you, and I'll show you what is Haller's index. This Haller's index was the question which was asked this year in your JIPMER exam, that in which disease do you use Haller's index. So Haller's index on CT is the ratio between the maximum transverse diameter and the minimum AP diameter in this patient. So we take a ratio of maximum transverse diameter and the minimum AP diameter, that is called as Haller's index. And if this index is greater than 3.25, that is usually taken as an indication for surgery. And why would these people present to you? Now, you can see in front of you, these patients would have, you know, specific cosmetic issues and psychological issues about their, you know, body morphology. But often they would be asymptomatic, but some of them will come to you with pulmonary function abnormality, with restrictive kind of pulmonary functions, and they may come to you with some kind of cardiac function abnormalities as well. But you look at the clinical picture, these patients also have cosmetic and psychological issues about their body wall deformity, which should not be underestimated. And the most famous or most important surgical procedure here for repair of this defect is called as NUSS procedure, described by Dr. NUSS here, and where this is also called as minimally invasive repair of pectus excavatum, in which you put these curved rods behind the sternum to correct the deformity, which is again a potential multiple choice question, as well as for a radiology resident working, or as a radiologist if you are working in a hospital where you have thoracic surgeries being done, you might see such x-rays in your follow-up. I think, you know, that is the key that we should know as a MBBS doctor or as a radiology resident about this procedure. Do follow us on Damn Silly channel on YouTube for more such integrated videos, and I look forward to your comments in the comment section and any topics that you feel we should add in the YouTube channel for our listeners. I'll be happy to do that. Thank you.